A very warm welcome to class 10 and the part which was been skipped or been missed by all of us, that is about the Gautam Buddha, right? And this chapter we have, yesterday we had a reading session and today it was like I'm going to explain you all this lesson. I'm just waiting for you all to join fast so that once if I begin now, it is going to be really if you all are going to join late, then you all will miss it. So that's what I expect from you all. Still, I can see many have not joined yet.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. So let's begin. Time is over. So I'm going to start with the, as usual, with the English Academy only, and we will move according to that. Anmol, you want to say something, beta?
No, my mistake, sorry.
It's okay. No, not an issue. I thought that you want to speak, sir. Speak out. Okay. So, let's begin. The summon at Benares. Now, first of all, tell me, what do you mean by the word summon? Do anyone can explain me or tell me what do we mean by summon? S-E-R-M-O-N. Summon ka matlab kya hota hai? What do you mean by that? Yes, Veeram, you can write.
Moral subject.
Moral subject. Nearby. Anyone else? Anyone else?
A religious text.
A religious text.
Who is saying that?
Scripture.
Riyanshi is saying something. Riyanshi, you want to say something? You will say something, I think so. Riyanshi?
Ma'am, someone joined with
no, ma'am, Kalan. No, ma'am.
Ma'am, like Prabhupada and all that is Saman. Ma'am, religious talk.
Yes, religious talk.
Perfect. Ma'am, a person who does religion service.
Yes.
Prabhupada in Hindi.
Yes. Perfect answer I'm getting. Really, very good. Very good. Very good answers. That means religious talks or jo hum kehte na jo mahapurush hote hain, like in your Jainism, you can give n number of examples, right? So those people, those who give the pravachan jo dete hain na, unko kehte hain sermon, right? So the sermon at Benares. We will move into the explanatory part. Why I am talking about Benares over here? Can anyone tell me why I am talking about Benares over here?
Ma'am, because Gautam Buddha went in Benares for schooling in Hindu scared culture university.
Yes, near Ganga River Bank. True. Anyone else would like to say? I heard few voice. I want to listen from others also.
It's a religious place.
It's a religious place, Harshit. Very true. Anyone else? Kya ho sakta? What can be the reason? Kyun Gautam Buddha se ye word jod raha hai, Benares? Anyone? Any one of you?
Ma'am.
Haan, Kushal?
Because his enlightenment came in Benares only.
Yes, he got his enlightenment in Benares. So here, the name of this particular chapter has become the Sermon at Benares. I will surely connect you all again back to this. Let me first explain you all this. What does this mean? Children, if you remember the ball pope, right? It has taught us that the in our life, there will be happiness and sadness simultaneously. And means getting attached to someone and means missing someone is also part and parcel of our life. So, जिंदगी में पाना और खोना तो लिखा ही हुआ है. It happens in all of us. It happens with all of us in our life, right? So, it is like कि इसका inner meaning यही है. It will show all of us that life is a place where you can have a taste of everything. You will feel like you are getting something, and you will also feel that कि हमसे कुछ चला जा रहा है, छूट रहा है. But here this particular saint, that is Gautam Buddha, wanted to know about that ki what is the thing which is actually giving sadness to one's life. Aisi kaun si cheez hai jo kisi ko dukh de rahi hai, dukh pahuncha rahi hai, aisa kya hai, what is that thing, that particular thing he wanted to know, and he wanted to move to this eternity and enlightenment and move ahead to make all of us know about it. So, is cheez ko kaise unhone paya? How did he got it? How did he went into the life? And how did he went ahead to know about all these things? This is the whole journey we will see in this chapter. This chapter is actually very small, children, but it is giving us lot of meaning. Means inner meaning is too much heavy, you know. It is giving us lots of values. कुछ सेकंड के लिए हमें बहुत खुशी होती है कि अरे यार चलो थोड़ा सा मैम की क्लास चल रही है, चलने दो, मैम को बोलने दो, वी आर प्लेइंग गेम्स ओवर हियर. सी नथिंग इज गोइंग टू हैपन टू मी चिल्ड्रन, नथिंग विल हैपन व्हेन यू ऑल गिव अस द कमेंट्स नाउ, नथिंग इज गोइंग टू हैपन टू मी बिकॉज आई हैव पास्ड माय लाइफ ऑफ लर्निंग सेशन एंड आई एम स्टिल लर्निंग फ्रॉम यू ऑल. बट चिल्ड्रन व्हाट यू ऑल आर गोइंग टू मिस, दैट इज अ बिग थिंग इन लाइफ. Because the conversation, the discussion, which is an healthy discussion in the class, this remains forever the same. But when you listen or study by your own, that knowledge you won't be getting, the knowledge which when we all are sitting and discussing. That's why I always tell you all to, you all are most welcome. Please join the class, enjoy the class, have a healthy discussion so that so many things will come out of it. Yes. So life mein har cheezon ka hona bahut zaruri hota hai. Ups and downs ka hona bahut zaruri hota hai. It is really needed, children. Okay. So let us start the class with this chapter.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello, Darshan.
Akshati, want to say something?
Ma'am, no, ma'am. Darshan was there, but okay. I had a doubt.
Yes.
That which means Buddha had enlightenment in which place?
Buddha had enlightenment in which place? Okay. आपको उस जगह का नाम नहीं पता बेटा?
नो मैम, बोध गया.
हाँ, बोध गया कहाँ पे है बेटा?
बिहार.
अच्छा, और यहाँ पे इन्होंने क्या पाया था? कौन से पेड़ के नीचे बैठे थे? कौन से पेड़ के नीचे बैठे थे ये?
बोधी ट्री.
यस, यहाँ पे इन्होंने क्या पाया?
नॉलेज
पाया. किस चीज का नॉलेज? व्हाट नॉलेज ही गॉट फ्रॉम हियर?
लाइफ
में दुख क्यों आता है, और आता है तो क्या क्या कारण होता है उसके पीछे. सो ही वॉन्टेड टू नो दिस. ओके, सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन. मैं आपसे फिर से बात करूंगी इस बारे में. आई विल कम बैक टू यू. अंडरस्टैंड टू बी द साइट ऑफ द एनलाइटमेंट और ग्रेट कुशल. ओके, फाइन. गौतम बुद्ध, यू कैन सी दिस ईयर बेटा, दिस इज अ बिफोर क्राइस्ट एंड आफ्टर. ये दिस इज अ टाइम ऑफ मिड एज, यू नो. उनका जन्म क्राइस्ट के जन्म से पहले हुआ था, उनका डेथ क्राइस्ट के जन्म से बाद हुआ था, राइट? बिगन लाइफ एज अ प्रिंस नेम्ड एज सिद्धार्थ गौतम, उनका जन्म एज अ प्रिंस हुआ था, एंड हिज नेम वॉज सिद्धार्थ गौतम, ही वॉज बॉर्न इन नॉर्दर्न इंडिया, बहुत बड़े घर में उनका जन्म हुआ था. Now, at 12, he was sent away for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures. A collection of books accepted as holy text, and 4 years later, he returned home to marry a princess. You all know, children, in the earlier times, the kids have been getting married with the small at in the small age only. Fine. At 12, he was sent away for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures. अच्छा, 12 साल की उम्र में he went for the Hindu sacred books के लिए उन्होंने पढ़ाई शुरू करी. Why he wanted to know? Because he wanted to know the Hindu culture, Hindu scripts, right? उस time पे Buddhism start नहीं हुआ था. Let me make it very clear. Hinduism is the base of all the Indian castes and creed, children. Let me make it clear. Anju ma'am has also told you many a times when she is teaching in SST classes. Hinduism is actually the base of all the caste and creed. From there, the bifurcation started. Hindu sacred scriptures, a collection of books accepted as holy texts like Rig Ved, Sam Ved, Atharv Ved, and Yajur Ved. And 4 years later, जब उन्होंने मैंने पढ़ाई करके वो वापस आया and he got married with a princess. Then he was also having a child, children, you know. I'll show you that page also. Yes. Now, at about the age of 25, the prince here, therefore, before now, shielded from the sufferings of the world. जब उनकी age 25 साल की हुई ना बेटा, at the age of 25, his consciousness actually started growing up. So he thought that ki yes, I need to move around the whole world to see this world. Until that time, he has not seen even any times. He has not seen the toughness of life, the sadness of life, shield from the sufferings of the world. While out hunting, chanced upon, came across by chance a sick man, then an aged man, then a funeral procession, and finally a monk begging for alms. When he was of 25 years of age, till that age, he has not seen any kind of problems in life, in the world, in the sufferings in the whole world. Now he went out for hunting one day. When he went out for hunting, he suddenly saw a man, an old man, a sick old man. Then an aged man, sick old aged man. Then he saw a funeral. Funeral means जब death हो जाती है तो जलाने के लिए जब हम लेके जाते हैं या दफनाने के लिए. At that time he saw this also. Then he saw a monk begging for alms. Alms means भीख मांगना. ALMS means भीख मांगना, begging. So when he saw all these things ना बेटा, a consciousness began in his mind, in his thoughts, in his views, that what is the reason? What is that particular thing? Ki the world is suffering from so many tough times, so many tough situations. What is the reason behind it? He started asking from his conscience only. Ki aisa kya hota hai jo duniya mein itna dukh dekhna padta hai? What is the reason behind it? उसका जड़ क्या है? So then he started to know about all these things more and more through different ways that we are going to see now. Now these sights so moved him that he at once went out into the world to seek enlightenment. इन चीजों ने उनको एकदम झंझोर दिया था कि माय गुडनेस इतना दुख कैसे हो सकता है लाइफ में. अ स्टेट ऑफ हाई स्पिरिचुअल नॉलेज ओके कंसर्निंग द सोरोज. क्यों उनको जो दुख देखते नहीं बन रहा था. सैडनेस कॉज्ड बाय लॉस डिसअपॉइंटमेंट ही हैड विटनेस्ड. उन्होंने जो देखा था ना जो जो तकलीफें उन्होंने देखी इट वॉज सो पेनफुल. एंड as a person he is a generous person na? So he got too much hurt that what is it I should know about it and I should move out. And he left everything, children, he left the whole family, he left his wife, he left his child, he left the whole means bolte na pura sansar ko tyag dena, right? And he went for the enlightenment to know about all the spiritual knowledge ki aisa hai kya. Right, concerning about the sorrows, the toughness of the life, what he saw while he went for hunting. He started recalculating himself and know about ki life mein kitni sari cheeze hoti hain, kitne ups and downs rehte hain, un cheezo ko overcome karke aage chalna, ye duniya sikhata hai. But Gautam Buddha wants to know the root cause of it. That's why he went for its enlightenment. Okay. He wandered to walk around for 7 years and finally sat down under a peepal tree. 7 years he wandered around, children. 7 saal se wo idhar se idhar ghumte reh gaye. He moved from each and every corner to know the people, to know this world, what not he did. He finished himself. He wanted to know and to reach to that enlightenment. Sat down under a, and at last, finally, he sat down under a peepal tree. Where he vowed. What do you mean by vowed, children? Solemnly promised to do a specified thing. जब आप किसी चीज पे focus कर लेते हो ना, when you focus yourself on something, when you make yourself focus, like I am focusing on to become a principal. So you are focusing on becoming a well-renowned person as a business person, as a doctor, as an engineer, as a photographer, as a whatever it is, whatever is your choice, as a chef, as a photographer, whatever it is, right? To reach to that point, you have some aim, you have a goal in life, right? We need to reach to it. Aur usko paane ke liye na bahut tapasya karni padti hai beta, right? Usko paane ke liye hame bahut tapasya karni hoti hai, and it's not a matter of joke that you will get within fraction of seconds. Okay, so this has to be done. So to reach to that particular place, fine. Now, enlightenment. After 7 years, he renamed the tree. जिस पीपल ट्री के नीचे जहाँ पे बैठे थे ना, उस ट्री का नाम दे दिया गया बोधि ट्री, ट्री ऑफ विजडम, and began to teach and to share his understandings. वहां बैठ के वो शिक्षा देने लगे, बांटने लगे, शेयर करने लगे. New understandings. At that point, he became known as the Buddha. Unko tab jana gaya the Buddha ke naam se, right? What do you mean by a Buddha? The awakened or the enlightened. Usko kehte Buddha. Jahan baithe the, uska naam de diya gaya Bodhi tree, tree of wisdom, children. Okay. After this paragraph, I would like to have a discussion because I'm feeling like it's a one-man show going on. Yes, the Buddha preached his first sermon, religious or moral talk, at the city of Banaras, most holy of the dipping places of the river Ganges. That sermon has been preserved and is given here. The Buddha preached his first sermon. Okay. Religious or moral talk means pehli baar jab unhone bola at the city of Banaras, most holy of the dipping. Okay. Dipping means bathing places of the river Ganges. That sermon has been preserved, maintaining in its original state and is given here. Means उन्होंने पहली बार जब सम्मान दिया था तो वो बनारस सिटी में था, right? Now, Kisa Gautami had. I can't see. Had only son and he died. In her grief, intense sorrow, she carried the dead child to all her neighbors, asking them for medicine, and the people said she has lost her senses. The boy is dead. At length, Kisa Gautami met a man who replied to her request, I cannot give thee medicine of thy child, but I know a physician who can. So, thy here means archaic form of your. Okay. मैं तुम्हारे दुख तो मैं तो दवाई नहीं दे सकता पर तुम्हारा दुख दूर कर सकता हूँ. What? How can I? I will tell you one address of one physician. You can go there and make your child cure. And the girl said, pray tell me, sir, who is it? And the man replied, go to Sakyamuni, the Buddha. Jao Buddha ke paas jao.
Sorry to interrupt you, ma'am. Sakyamuni means?
Sakyamuni, yes. Perfect question. Thank you for asking at least. सक्यमुनि मीन्स जो सालों से आराधना करता हो. मीन्स लाइक इयर्स एंड इयर्स आफ्टर जब हम तपस्या करते हैं ना एंड वी रीच टू आवर एम दैट दोस पीपल आर नोन एज सक्यमुनि. ओके. एंड जो सभी दुख को हर सकता है, ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स ही कैन क्योर इट, दोस पीपल्स आर दोस मॉन्क्स आर नोन एज सक्यमुनि. ओके. Am I clear?
Yes.
The Buddha answered, I wanted a handful of mustard seeds. A quantity, handful means a quantity that fills the hand. And when the girl in her joy promised to procure this, obtain, get in, the Buddha added, the mustard seed must be taken from a house where no one has lost a child, husband, parent or friend. जाओ वहां से जाके मस्टर्ड सीड लेके आओ जहां पे किसी के भी किसी ने भी अपने बच्चे हस्बैंड पेरेंट या फ्रेंड को खोया ना. ओके. सो ही सेड दिस स्टेटमेंट टू हर दैट लेडी. द मस्टर्ड सीड्स कैन ओनली कम फ्रॉम अ हाउस. सी द वर्डिक्ट्स बाय गिवन बाय relative has died. So now she will be in problem. Let us see what happens. Poor Kisa Gautami now went from house to house and the people pitied, felt sorry for her misfortune. Her and said, here is mustard seed, take it. But kisi na kisi ke ghar mein koi na koi relative to नहीं रहा होगा. बट वेन शी आस्क्ड डिड अ सन और अ डॉटर फादर और अ मदर डाई इन योर फैमिली दे आंसर्ड हर अलास द लिविंग आर फ्यू बट द डेड आर मेनी. नाउ व्हाट टू डू. very tough situation. Do not remind us of our deepest grief, and there was no house but some beloved one had died in it. Means in every family, what she saw that ki one or the other person has died. So how it is possible, from which family she will get those mustard seeds then? She was in a big confusion. She was tired of asking and roaming around here and there. Kisa Gautami became weary, means tired and hopeless, and sat down at the wayside. Wayside means roadside. Watching the lights of the city as they flickered, shone unsteadily up and were extinguished again. Means banna, bujhna, bandhona, open hona, chalu hona. Means it was continuously been done. She was tired of roaming here and there. She was frustrated. She sat down on the roadside and started thinking, now what shall she do? At last, the darkness of the night reigned, means ruled, was prevalent everywhere. And she considered the fate of men, that their lives flicker up and extinguish again. Now, this is the lesson of life. Children, please pay attention. In everyone's life, sometime there will be light, sometime there will be darkness. What is the meaning behind it? Can anyone tell me? Any one of you? This is the lesson what has been given by Gautam Buddha to everyone. Yes?
Man, every person who come in this earth, yes, dies one or the day.
True, very true. Anything else? Anything else you are getting out of it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, this line also tells us that sadness and happiness are the part of life. They just, yes, come and go, but we have to stand by it.
Very true. Means whenever there is darkness, we know that the light will come. When there is light, we also should know that darkness will come. Okay. So this is the bitter truth and the fact of life. And she thought to herself, how selfish am I in my grief? Death is common to all. Yet in this valley of desolation, desolation means great unhappiness, there is a path that leads him to immortality, the ability to live forever. Who has surrendered all selfishness? And she wants to say that ye jo mera bachcha ab nahi raha, this is also a part of my life. I have to face this, because it might happen that this is the bitter truth of life, that the time span of life for his child, her child, was only that much only. So she has to accept it. Gautam Buddha wants to tell that she has to accept the death, accept the truth of this bitter truth of the life. That's why he said that, okay, fine, I will save. I mean, the moment he said that I will save him or I will do something, so she thought that he might do some miracle or something like that and the child will again be alive. But it was not like that. He wanted to teach her the truth. And yes, this is the beautiful way how he has taught. Don't you all think so? And she thought to herself, how selfish am I? Okay, it is done. I have already explained. The Buddha said the life of the mortals, those who are bound to die in this world, is troubled and grief and combined with pain. For there is not any means by which those who that have been born can avoid dying. After reaching old age, there is death of such a nature are living beings. This is what I wanted to tell you all, that yes, before many years there was one poem in class 9th, Seven Stages of Life. If you all have studied or if you all know about this poem, please go through this poem. I have taught many years ago in 9th class, when I was teaching in 9th class. Do read it once if you get time. This will show you how the child takes birth and the death arises. So this is what we have to accept it, children. Okay?
That means it's a type of the whole journey.
Yes, this is the whole journey it will show you. As ripe fruits are early in danger of falling, so mortals when born are always in danger of death. Okay? So this is the fact, the bitter truth, which has been explained over here. I will end with this line. Today's class, a little bit is very little bit is left, but yes, I need 10 more minutes to discuss. I will repeat this line and please listen to me very carefully. As ripe fruits are early in danger of falling, agar koi phal jaldi pak jata hai na aur wo jaldi girta hai to wo thoda sa dangerous ho jata hai. Okay. So mortals when born are always in danger of death. So aisa dekhna ki jo achhi cheeze hoti hai na life mein wo bahut jaldi hum kho dete hain. So we need to accept this truth. Fine. So very deep meaning it has got. So you need to understand the meaning. We will continue from here itself in our next class tomorrow. Fine. So understand it, go through it, and I can see the numbers is continuously getting reduced. So this is not good. Fine, children.
So, okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Good day.
Thank you so much. I know you are tired. Take care. Bye bye.
Bye, ma'am. Have a nice day.
Thank you, Bitta.
Bye. Bye, ma'am.
Bye, Bitta.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, Bitta. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye.
Bye.